What would it be and would you call it to his face? If you were faced with him in all his glory, what would you ask if you had just one question?
Hey everybody, how are you? What's happening? This is Reverend Wayne Stills. Reverend Wayne Stills for the question of the week. And I'm here with Audrey Whitehead. How's it going, Audrey? How are you?
Hey,
how you doing? And this is Miracles Everywhere. Miracles Everywhere. Miracles are everywhere. Then wherever you go, that's where miracles are. They're in your mind. Where you change your mind, and transform consciousness, change your paradigm, and things get better. That's how they are. We need to do nothing for that to happen. The less we do, body-wise at least, the less we do, the better. You know? And that's how you realign yourself with God that way. You know, you realign yourself. It's not about acknowledging your separation and realigning yourself with God. And you can do that just by changing your opinion about who you are and who Jesus is and who the Spirit is and what the Spirit is. I read the course and I go, you know what, I'm going to change my mind about my point of view about life. As far as I'm concerned, this is true.
Okay.
10 minutes ago, it wasn't true. Now it is.
Mm-hmm.
So yesterday this wasn't true, I've changed my mind, now it is. That's a change of mind. That's what it means. That's the miracle. The miracle is, I used to think life was once, that's it. Now I know life's forever and I'm innocent. That's a change of mind. That's the miracle. You know, I've changed my mind. I'm choosing love, I'm choosing truth, I'm choosing goodness, I'm choosing happiness. There's a comfort to know that this is not real. It's all pretend,
right?
You know, it's a comfort. It feels real. It feels real, but it's not. And that's a comfort.
Mm-hmm.
You got to change your mind to feel that way. You got to change your mind to believe that.
Oh, yeah.
Because we're not, our ego sets up a situation where we're not able to just believe that.
Right.
Or to even know that, to experience that. We have to remember that we have a mind, that we have a spirit, that we have a heart. We should remember these things. We're not set up for that. We're not here for that. We didn't come here to remember that. We came here to forget that.
Right. Yeah.
So everything is set up here to make us forget that. The entire dream is set up to make us forget who we are.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have to remember who we are. And as we do that, we remember who we are. We make changes in our mind, changes in our consciousness. You know, we're loving each other, caring for each other, being compassionate, giving, and everything starts to get better. But it happens little by little, lifetime by lifetime.
Yeah.
Turtle by turtle.
Turtle by turtle.
All right. So I'll shut up now. And what do you got for me? What question you got for me?
Okay. Well, I've been thinking about a song that you play often. It's called Praise Him.
Ah, Praise Him by Carmen.
By Carmen. Praise Him.
Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him at noontime. Praise Him in the evening. Praise Him. And that's a song.
Right.
Short and sweet.
Just like me.
Yes. Yes. I don't know your height. I haven't met you. I've only met you.
Yes. Well, I'm only about, I used to be 5'2". Now I'm 5'1 and a half.
Why are you shrinking? You're a youngster.
It just happens.
I see.
I'm melting.
5'2". My wife is 5'2", 5'3", right around there.
Right?
Yeah. See? And I'm 6'2". I'm 6'2".
Wow.
I'm taller than her.
Yeah.
I'm the shortest in my family.
Oh, so you got my
mother's 6'3".
Oh,
no, I'm kidding. But my father, both my brothers are bigger than me, but I'm the shortest male in the family.
Nice.
My mother's 5'8", so she's still pretty big, my mother.
Yeah, she's tall.
She's, especially when she was younger, she was one of the tallest ones.
Yeah.
You know, so her mother, my grandmother was 5'8", too, so she was huge for her time.
Yes, very tall. Would be. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's incredible. Wow. Wow.
Yeah, Abraham Lincoln was 6'4".
No, I didn't know.
Yeah, that was wild. That tall that was back in that day. Ooh. He must have been a monster running for president.
Right?
The big top hat. He must be like a 7-foot monster. He must be real.
Wow.
All right. So what was the question?
So in thinking of that song, what do you do to praise God, and what is the best way to praise God? What can I be doing that?
Well,
not doing, but
yeah, I know what you mean. Well, it's funny because as you said, it's not so much about doing. It is about doing to a certain extent, but it's not about doing to get something from God.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about earning your way to God or anything. It's just about doing certain things to get a better understanding of who you are.
Yeah,
that's what I do. You know, I try to understand God versus you do the course.
Mm-hmm.
You're doing the course not because you earn points with anybody. You earn points with God. God, when you do the course, you earn points with me. Because if that was the case, the more you did the course, the better off you get with God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, or the better you did the course, the better off you. Now you want to understand. The better you did the course, it means you understand the course better.
Yeah.
For you in your life, you don't need to do it. What I want to try to do is I try to align myself with God, like I said before.
Mm-hmm.
We accept from God. Accepting the atonement for myself means that I accept that I am separated from God.
Mm-hmm.
In my perspective, I am separated from God, and I want to become one with God.
Right.
So how do I do that? Well, first I realized the only way to do that is because I need to accept God can do it, and I can't.
Mm.
I mean the small I, the body. Which I am most of the time.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at I do nothing, I need to do nothing. It says we put all of our faith in the body.
Yeah.
We think the body can do everything.
Right.
Yeah. We give no faith to the spirit, to God. None.
Mm.
If we can just switch that.
Right.
If we give all of our faith to the spirit, realizing that the body doesn't do anything. The more it does, the more it screws up. So there really is. So the more, if I can get that going, if I can get that idea going any way I can,
mm-hmm.
even if it means just bowing down to nature,
right,
to the grand vastness of it all, realizing that everything I'm looking at is in my consciousness. You know, in chapter 31, I think it is, he says, "You think you can't do what I'm asking you to do? Have you seen what you've done?"
Mm. Wow, the miscreating.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Look how powerful you are.
Mm.
You can do what I'm asking you to do, because it's creating. It's a heck of a lot easier than miscreating.
Right.
You do out of your way to miscreate. And you did it. So if I look at the stars, and I go, that star is in my consciousness. Wow, that's pretty heavy duty.
Yeah.
So I can, now I'm separate. Now I'm moving closer and closer to oneness.
Yeah.
I am the infinite universe. I am the eternal universe. I am one with everything and everyone around me. So it's not so much I'm praising God in the traditional sense. I'm not saying, oh, poor Lord God.
Yeah.
Like
right.
It's more like I am coming to an understanding of who God is.
Mm.
Which is what the Course is all about. Take a look around you where there's nothing around you means anything. Getting you to a place where you can look behind the physicality. When you look behind the forms, because the forms are not really there anyhow. When you look past it, you can see the light that's behind it. I can realize that there's no distance between me and this computer. There's no distance between me and you, because distance itself is a part of form.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Distance itself is an idea.
Mm-hmm.
These truths that I'm thinking about right now are how I praise God. By thinking about it all day long.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that in the New Testament, supposedly the only commandment that's not in the New Testament that's in the Old Testament is the commandment to keep the Sabbath?
Oh.
That's not in the New Testament. Every other of the Ten Commandments that are also in the New Testament. The reason why is that in the New Testament they want you to celebrate it every day, not once a week.
Right.
So,
wow.
so they don't have it in there. Now, I don't know if that's true enough for everyone, but that's where it's the idea behind it. Now, so if you think of it that way, every single day I praise God.
Mm-hmm.
So think about it all the time. Thinking about the
Yes.
All the time.
Yeah.
It's not once a week. Is that only when I do the course?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's every day, all the time. I mean, especially when you're doing the course a lot, because you all day long you're doing them every 10 minutes, yeah, every hour. You know, but the idea is that all day long, until your thoughts become the course's thoughts.
Hmm.
Until your mind is filled with the thought, the mind is the mind of the course, the mind of Christ.
Hmm. Nice.
Yeah, and then that's the other way. That's how you praise God, because it says, "I need to do nothing." Is loyalty? It's about absolute loyalty to God.
Right.
What it is? It's loyalty to God. It's commitment to God. It means God. You don't have to do anything. Why? Because God will do everything.
Wow. Yeah.
What do I got to do? I could sit right here all day long and say, God, bring me everything I need. What God could say? He said, I can't.
Yeah.
You have to do certain things, and then I can do certain things. Why? Because that's the only way I can function.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of God is that? A weak God.
Right.
He doesn't need me to do anything. Remember, I mean, the Holy Spirit says at some point, I don't know if I remember where, he says, I don't need you at all. Remember, better you just watch and observe. That's why it says that our best bet is just observe what we're doing on the movie screen.
Right. And through our body.
Yeah, just observe and sit next to Jesus and discuss what's real.
Mm.
Don't get involved in the movie.
Mm.
You know, I mean, if that helps people. Certain people need that first.
Right, yeah.
Now, first, you're the hero of the dream. You're the hero of the movie first. You star in the movie. Okay, now you got that, sit back for the movie. Mm-hmm. Watch it. Just observe it.
Yeah.
So that's what I do. Every single day I try to connect to the truth of who I am, that I'm not separate from God. And I also try to remember, though, that's not necessarily going to catapult me into living the truth every day. That there's plenty of times, most of the time, as it says, I don't live outside of time.
Mm-hmm.
I live in the body, in time.
Right, yeah.
Because if I think the opposite, then I'm going to enter into a nice little fat delusion, thinking I'm Mr. Big Shot.
Right, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So this way I stay low-key. I just, look, most of the time I am in the body.
Yeah.
Most of the time I am in the ego. So I need to constantly praise God, which is to say I need to constantly be connecting to the truth and becoming a channel for the expression of love. Becoming an open channel.
Open channel, yeah.
You know, otherwise there's too much love in you, and then you become like one of those, as I said before, those light bulb that burns out. You explode with pleasure. You know, a light bulb, when it burns out, it gets really light first.
Yes.
And then you know, it's out, the fuse blows. That's what when you hoard all the love and you don't give it to anybody, it builds up in your system until eventually,
boom.
And it's really light. You're like, wow, that was fun. Yeah. And next morning, the light bulb burnt out. You know what I mean?
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah. But so you try to connect to the truth of who you are, and how you can connect slowly and truly, to the light of God, to the Creator, and the Creator within. And that's, yeah, and then you're praising God.
Praising God. Thank you. Wow.
What do you think?
I don't think. I don't do anything.
I know.
I think that's awesome.
The key is to have discussions, to talk about things, to understand things. That's not doing. Doing is when you get up and I have to get up and do this. I have to do that. If I don't do this, then God's never going to come through for me. He's only going to come through for me if I have to. The body must get things done.
Yeah. Yeah.
I, as the body, as the ego, must do thousands of things every single day, or I won't get anything in my, I'll die in the streets.
Right.
I must compete. I must take. I must have, do, and be everything to everybody, and to myself especially. I must get, or else.
Yeah.
No, I must get up at 9 o'clock and work till 9 o'clock and every day, blah, 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 and all that kind of stuff. I need to do nothing means no.
Mm-hmm.
Chill.
Chill and be moved.
Yeah, you have all the time in the world. And people say, what? I have all the time in the world? Come on. You do.
Yeah.
And that's what it means to live forever.
Right.
You don't rush from one life to the next. You just go peacefully from one life to the next. One life, next life, next life, next life. So eventually he's so calm, he just smooth your way up to the next dimension. No one can rush their way to the next dimension.
Yeah.
To higher consciousness. No one can think, oh my God, I'm this consciousness. You have to be calm and cool, relaxed.
Yeah.
Without any stress.
Yeah.
Then you'll be outside of time more often than you're in time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm late for things because I'm just,
that's okay.
Ooh.
That's okay. You know, because you find yourself, it's just, things will just move you in the right direction. If you're late for things, then you were supposed to be late. You're on time, yeah. Somehow late.
Yeah, perfect. Wow. All right,
so that was all, if I answered the question or not. I did definitely talk for a while.
That was great. I think that was awesome. I think it reinforces this watching the mind like a hawk thing that I learned back with Lisa Natoli. And at first that was really difficult for me to do because there was too much going on in my brain. So with the help of everything unfolding the way it is and the spirit, it's really coming into that. Yeah, I think about it all the time. I'm always thinking of, you know, what am I thinking? Where am I feeling? What's my center here? Or, you know, where am I coming from?
And then the funny thing about center is just let whatever's there be there without trying to get rid of it. And your center becomes wherever you happen to be.
Oh, beautiful.
That's what you want to do. You want to be wherever you are, and wherever you are, be okay. So if you happen to be sitting there and suddenly you feel stressed out, let yourself be a stressed out being.
Yeah.
If you feel lost and confused, allow the lost and confusion to be there. Mm-hmm. Don't try it, because if you try to get rid of it, then what you're doing is just, you're listening to what confusion says to do.
Right, yeah.
Anger says yell at that person.
Yeah.
But what you're really doing is you're trying to get rid of the anger that way, by yelling at that, blaming that person. So what you want to do instead is let the anger say whatever it wants, tell you what to do, and then say, nah, I'm not going to do that. But if you want to say, if you want to sit down and have a beer, you can stay here. Well, you stick around. I'll let you be here.
Yeah.
But and you can jabber on. You can talk all you want. You can be as babble all you want. But I'm just, I'm going to do what I want to do, not what you tell me to do.
Nice.
The anger has no hold over you. He'll just sit there and babble, even if he talks up a storm. And to anything, any experience you don't want to have, let the experience just take over. Let it bury you. Let it overwhelm you. Because it won't hurt you. It's just emotions.
Yeah. Right.
It only hurts you if you pretend they're not there.
Yeah.
Yeah, then they try to live no matter what.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So anywhere you are, you can be centered.
Mm.
Just allow those, whatever you're feeling, to be there moment by moment. Yeah, and then
nice.
That's another way to praise God, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wherever you are, God is. There's no place where God's not. So really, there's no center. There is no non-center in the universe. The universe is infinite. Cosmos is infinite. So everywhere you are is the center. Right?
Yes.
Everywhere you are is infinite. If the universe is infinite, if I'm here, there's just as much space on this side as that side.
Yeah.
If I'm here, same thing. No matter where you put yourself, there's just as much space around you as there would be if you went somewhere else, because the universe is infinite.
Wow.
So wherever you end up, you are centered.
That reminds me of driving. When you look off to the horizon, it's always in that distance at the same space.
Yeah, exactly. You're always in the same center.
Wow.
And so there really is no left, right, up, down. All that is the construct on a planet.
Yeah.
You know, but there really is no, those are all constructs made up by humans.
Wow.
You know, made up by life forms, I guess you could say, who need that awareness or for themselves.
Mm.
But in space, there's no up or down.
Right? Yeah.
You know? Yeah. There's only infinite, there's only the eternal moment to now. Even time is a joke. All time is motion that we count.
Wow.
One,
yeah.
Two, yeah. Three, and then we are, that's that. Then every 365 motions is a year. We'll call it a year.
Yeah, we'll call that a year. Yeah.
That's a year. And what a year means that we banked up our body for 1 year. And after a bunch of those years, we die.
Yeah.
You know, I was making stuff up.
Yeah.
And 7 days, that came from the Bible.
Yeah.
Total invention. Before that, who knows what they had?
Yeah, I don't know what they did before the calendars came out. How did, what did they, must have done the notches on the bedposts.
probably something like that. Notches on the cave, doors, something like that. But yeah.
Whereas Pat Benatar says, before I put another notch on my lipstick case.
Ah, so that's what they did. The lipstick case, that's not, of
course. You know?
I haven't heard her music for a long time, Pat Benatar.
Oh, wow. 1980s. I was just singing a couple of her songs the other night.
She sang that song about the Love is a Battlefield.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I remember that song.
Yeah.
Love is a Battlefield.
Yeah. Whoa.
Hit me with your best shot. That was her too, right?
Good one, too.
Yeah. 1980s. She was big in the 1980s. She was a tough chick. That was her thing.
I love her. I love her. Very good. So, yeah.
All right. So, yeah, cool. So, that's the question of the week.
Yeah.
Anything you want to add to the thing?
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for listening. Short but sweet. Hopefully, I helped out. Hopefully, we helped out. And I want to thank Oddsy, the Weird Oz, Wizard of Odds. without her producing and managing this whole affair, we'd be nowhere doing nothing. Which is the truth. So God bless and love you all, and we'll see you next week.
Love you. Peace.
Please, absolutely. Well, bye-bye.
Yeah, God is